On to another commodity supply concern, the Philippine Agriculture Department to seek clarification on the real situation of onion supply in the country. Now, this amid warnings of a possible shortage this year. Senior Undersecretary Domingo Panganiban says there have been no orders for any onion importation in the last 4 months.
Hindi natin malamang kung anong totoo. Marami nagsasabi, maraming onion sa Pilipinas. Marami rin naman nagsasabi, walang onion sa Pilipinas. Ang sa aming sinasabi, titingnan natin kung talagang walang onion sa Pilipinas.
In a House probe, Bureau of Plant Industry Director Glenn said, government is considering importing 8,000 metric tons of white onions this year. Meanwhile, a Philippine lawmaker renews calls for law enforcement agencies to look into the possibility of a cartel in the onion industry. Marikina 2nd District Representative Stella Kimbo believes the previous spike in onion prices was due to the alleged cartel. Price of onions in the country soared by as much as 700 pesos per kilo.
At the core of this is an onion cartel theory, which is really about the Philippine Vieva Group of Companies, a fully vertically integrated corporation, an SEC-registered corporation established in 2013. Its incorporators are corporations that are involved in local trading, importation, cold storage, warehousing, and trucking. Its majority owner, who appears to be Lilia or Lea Cruz,
the Marcos administration eyes reviving the Philippine Sugar Corporation to boost the commodity's production and strengthen the industry. That government-owned and controlled corporation was ordered abolished in 2018 due to supposed overlapping functions with the Sugar Regulatory Commission. But after meeting with the sugar industry stakeholders, Marcos believes farmers need the services of PhilSugCorp. The agency was formed in 1983 to provide funding for the acquisition and rehabilitation of sugar mills.
It provides it's financing for farmers, especially for cooperatives and farmers associations, yung mga tinatawag na block. Ngayon, hindi masyado silang nakakapagtrabaho dahil they tried to abolish the PhilSugCorp in 2019, I think. Ngunit hindi na-abolish, nandiyan pa sila. Kaya bubuhayin natin at babaguhin natin, titignan natin kung ano yung mga pagbabago para makapag-adjust tayo dito sa sitwasyon natin ngayon.
Marcos, the concurrent agriculture secretary, also bears more details about the government's planned importation of 150,000 metric tons of sugar.
We agreed on an importation schedule and how we will open up the importation to all of the traders. In the end, we will still continue to favor, in terms of buying, local production over importation.
Environmental group Greenpeace not in favor of President Marcos's decision to extend the service contract of Malambaya gas field. For Greenpeace, it just shows the administration's bias towards dirty energy. A consortium member, Prime Energy, meanwhile commits to ensure a stable and cleaner power supply for the country. Prime Infra Chairman Enrique Razon believes the latest development will help the country achieve energy security and independence. Three projects in Palawan under the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, with the U.S. already completed. Facilities including ammunition storage, command and control fusion, and an above-ground fuel tank have been built in the Antonio Bautista Air Base, an existing EDCA site in Puerto Princesa. Now, the construction of an air base on Balabac Island, one of the four additional EDCA sites in the country, is also underway.
We're looking na matapos ito as soon as we can dahil time is of the essence, alam naman natin. We have to fast track. Na-decide din lang ito na it will be one of the EDCA sites, diba? So there will be planning. May mga plano pa na kung ano talaga ang mga constructions pa. But for the meantime, ito government funded projects muna yung ginagawa natin. Because hindi lang naman sa atin yan. Ang atin, pag i-decide pa nga eh. And sa side naman ng counterparts, dami ding mga procedures that they have to follow. Kasi subject to approval.
Philippine and Vietnam officials eye close collaboration in pushing for the code of conduct in the South China Sea. Filipino diplomats concluded 2 days of talks Tuesday with their Vietnamese counterparts in Ha Long, Vietnam. The meeting also marked the 10th year since both sides began discussing maritime and ocean cooperation. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department said both countries agreed to work towards an effective and substantive conclusion to the Code of Conduct, or COC. The COC has long been on the agenda of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. It was conceptualized to reduce territorial conflict in the South China Sea, but the framework itself has yet to be finalized. The Philippines and Vietnam are both claimants to parts of the South China Sea, along with China, Malaysia, and Brunei.
More criminal complaints filed against suspended Philippine lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. And meanwhile, he dismissed as fake news claims that he was returning home Wednesday from a prolonged stay overseas. More in this report.
It was the most anticipated flight that did not come to be. Suspended Representative Arnulfo Teves Jr. was supposed to return to the Philippines on Wednesday, at least according to a reliable source of Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla. But no Teves showed up in any Philippine airport, prompting the lawmaker to taunt the Justice Chief.
You want a more reliable source? Sino bang reliable source? Yung source nila or ako? Okay, fake news. Dapat tinanong muna nila ako bago sila nagsalita sa mga decision ko, di ba?
It was Remulla who announced Tuesday that Teves might return to the country, having secured a homebound ticket after having been gone for more than 2 months since his U.S. trip. Teves has since been reported to be in Cambodia before seeking asylum in Timor-Leste. Teves is tagged as the alleged mastermind in the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo and 9 others when armed men opened fire inside Degamo's residence in Pamplona, Negros Oriental on March 4. The lawmaker had denied involvement, calling the charges trumped up, while his lawyer promised he will eventually return.
Asan ba siya? Paano siya magsasabi ng ganun? The flight is an indication of guilt. By any language, by any jurisdiction, by any legal system, flight is an indication of guilt.
The Philippine National Police said it is ready should Teves decide to return home.
Kasi ang mahirap dyan kung may mangyari sa kanya or kung may threat sa kanya, di natin alam. So it's better that we will provide all the appropriate security to make sure that yung ating si Congressman Teves ay will be properly accorded with these security arrangements.
Despite Teves' absence in the country, the National Bureau of Investigation proceeded to file murder complaints against him before the Department of Justice Wednesday. NBI Director Medardo De Lemos led the filing of the complaints. Remulla previously identified Teves as the executive producer of the killings, while his former aide, Marvin Miranda, was supposedly the casting director. 11 suspects, including Miranda, have earlier been charged in court, but it's only now, more than 2 months since the killing, that murder complaints have been lodged against Teves before the DOJ. He is facing other murder complaints with the DOJ over several killings in Negros Oriental in 2019 and illegal possession of firearms wraps. Authorities have yet to release a copy of the complaint.
Too early. Huwag muna. Kasi ano yan eh, rise of the accused pa yan. Mabuti na na let it be there first.
But a prior resolution tagged Teves in 2 previous failed attempts to kill Degamo. The first in December 2022 using a rocket-propelled grenade, and the second one in February this year through a sniper during a mass wedding. Remulla previously said that 7 to 8 suspects pointed to Teves' involvement, with 5 suspects claiming they saw the lawmaker's face through a video call with Miranda. Miranda himself allegedly escaped using Teves' helicopter. Meanwhile, the Secretary General of the House of Representatives says expulsion remains an option if Teves fails to show up at the lower chamber. The lawmaker's 60-day suspension will end on May 22.
Hindi natin masabi kung ano yung gagawin talaga ng Committee on Ethics on this. Kasi walang precedent eh, na after the 60-day suspension, ano mangyayari. In the end, it's really the whole membership who will have to decide.